Shortcuts, shortcuts, shortcuts. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about sharing just a few more Blender shortcuts. Yes, I know there are so many and I'm hoping to help with this video. So first, we're going to cover just those few more shortcuts that I think you might appreciate, because they come sort of, most of them anyway, come from a CAD perspective. And then what I'm gonna do is share with you a document that I've created that's gonna have every single shortcut that we talk about in the series, along with extra notes, where to use them, what the name is, and the shortcut itself. And I wanna show you how to use this document in case you forget what the shortcut is. And then from there, hopefully you'll be able to learn these shortcuts slowly but surely, and they will become ingrained within your precision workflow. We're at a point now in our Blender Precision series that we've almost grasped all the fundamentals, and there are a few more shortcuts that I want to show you just before we go. Yes, this video is going to be sort of a two thing. First, I want to show you a couple of shortcuts that I haven't shown you just yet, and I want to show you how we can navigate through all the shortcuts that I've already taught you, and we'll do a slight, very quick overview of the shortcuts as well. So first, let's go ahead and see these extra shortcuts that I want to show you. Now, why am I showing you these? Because these are shortcuts that you might be wanting because you might have come from another precision workflow and you're just wondering how on earth does Blender not have this. So let's go ahead and go over those right now. The first one is Quad View. And this is done with Ctrl-Alt-Q, which brings up the classic quad view that we're all used to. Now, there isn't a quick way to just go straight into this one, like this is what I want to see. What you have to do is go back to the 3D one, go out of it, and then remember that you've got your 7, 9, 1, and 3 to go into your different views. Next, what I want to show you is bringing up the statistics to somewhere a little bit more visible, because these statistics that we have down here are going to become very important in the next coming videos, and that is activated up here in overlays and put on statistics, and that brings it up here to somewhere very visible for us. Next is our viewport pie chart. Now, pie menu, excuse me. And that's by pressing Z, and that brings up our rendered material view, wire view, and solid view. Yes, this is very much our shift Z for wired, but I just want to bring this up because it can be quite useful to just have it here. Another one is snapping always on. Now you can turn on snapping to always be on by clicking this little magnet. Let's turn it to vertex. So then when we're moving our 3D cursor, it will snap always, and then it will use control to turn off snapping. Now, another way of turning this on and off is with Shift Tab, and that's how you'll go ahead and turn on and off constant snapping. This is completely your preference here, how you'd like to have this. Now, we've realized that there's a hell of a lot of shortcuts, so there is a shortcut to create your own shortcuts, and this is called the Quick Favorites. You open this menu with Q. Now, this Quick Favorites is fantastic for creating your own little shortcut menu that is tailored for your own workflow. So for instance, we have our Shift S snapping menu and cursor to world origin or selection to cursor. Let's go ahead and put these both into something. So let's go and right click. Oh, that doesn't work. Now, you might have thought that would have worked because here it says right click on buttons to add them to the list. Well, pie menus are not buttons, they're pie menus. So we have to go diving to find this one. And that is going to be an object, snap, and then here we have our 3D cursor menu. So let's go ahead and let's go for this one here of cursor to world origin. Let's right click on it, add to quick favorites. And let's also do selection to cursor, right click, add quick favorites. And why not? Let's add one more, which is here. If we right click, we go into our object context menu, which is actually our next shortcut. And let's go to our set origin. And then here, let's go with origin to 3D cursor. Let's right click in there and add quick favorites. So now when we hit Q, you will see that we get our own little quick favorites menu of our shortcuts that we use very often without having to go to an object, right click it, and then find it. So we can just hit Q and it'll go straight to it. We can go selection to cursor and that's it done. Now, like I just mentioned, I consider the right click a shortcut. Now, why is this? Now, we've been using it, but I haven't explained why we use it so much. This is the context menu. As you see, object context menu. And depending on what you have selected, it was going to change what you have here. So if we select a light and right click, it will give you light options. If you select a camera and right click, it's going to give you camera options. The right click is an incredibly powerful shortcut that you might have undervalued. And the very last thing that I want to point out isn't a shortcut, but it's very much shortcut related, which if you look down here at our bar, you're going to see it gives you hints, tooltips, when you're doing operations and actions. So let's go ahead and select this cube. Let's hit G to move it. And you're going to see it now gets populated with a whole bunch of secondary shortcuts. All of these shortcuts that I have shown you before. So that's something that I just wanted to quickly show you. So just quickly, from this point onwards, I'm covering the document that I've created to find shortcuts that you may have forgotten. So for those of you that feel completely concrete about Blender shortcuts, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching. And for those of you that are struggling with shortcuts just a teeny tiny bit, let's go ahead and show you how to use this document so you can sort of find any shortcuts you can forget. So yes, Blender has an absolute mountain of shortcuts, and I've heard you in the comments that yes, it is very annoying that there's so many shortcuts, but I'm sorry, that's just how mesh modeling works. Remember that all of these shortcuts are right here. When we're talking about an object, they're probably going to be right here. If you are unsure, you can also hit the space and search it. But on top of that, I've created this here. Now, this is all the shortcuts that I've mentioned throughout the series, as well as what video they're part of, what viewport mode or operation they rely to, and what it does, along with some additional notes. Now, this might be a little out of date here and there as videos come out, but I'll do my absolute best to populate this as we go along. So now, more than anything, I'm not going to go through every single one of these because that's going to just be boring, but I'm going to go ahead and show you how to use this Airtable. By the way, if you're interested in Airtable, I also have a link down below for you to sign up to it. It's free and it's awesome, and you can do some crazy things like this here. So let's go ahead and let's figure this out. So we're wanting to know how to do maybe origin, and we didn't know what the snapping menu is. So let's go over here and let's go ahead and take a look at what we've got here. So we have all of this. We're going to go searching. Let's go here. Let's search, find in view. Let's put in snap. And you will see that this gives you a lovely little drop down where we can go through here and see, oh, perfect. 3D cursor snapping menu. We now know that it's Shift and S. It works in edit mode and object mode, and it's part of video part 6 right here. So great. That's how that works. So now we know that right here, Shift S is what we were looking for. Now, maybe we didn't quite know what the shortcut was for moving. We completely forgot what that was. So let's go ahead and go here and let's put in move. And you'll have, we have cancel movement. That's not what we're looking for. Movement here, move. Oh, move. Fantastic. Move is G. And it works in edit mode and object mode, and it's part 8. Okay, fantastic. So now let's go back into here and we can go with our G. Great. So let's say we know how to duplicate. Let's go to Shift D. And how do we go ahead and join these again? It can't remember. Well, first of all, without looking at that, let's take a look at how we would use a different menu. Let's go space. Let's just type in join. And we have right here, object join, control J. Great. Now, how do I unjoin these? Well, we can't do it out of here. So let's remember what that was. Let's go back into here. So we're trying to separate an object here. So let's type it in here, Separate. Oh, it looks like it's right here. Separate object is P. Ah, it only works in edit mode. Okay, so now we know that it only works in edit mode. Let's go into edit mode. And now what we're wanting to do is let's remember what it was to select a whole geometry, a loose mesh. So let's go ahead. I think that was over here. If we type in loose, oh look, it's coming up in the extra notes. Used to select linked data like loose objects. In edit mode, it's Control L. Brilliant. So now we can do Control L. And now we know that P is for parting. We can do it by selection and that's it. So I've created this for you. And let me know how I can make this work even better for you. Yes, I understand there's a mountain of shortcuts and it just keeps growing. But I promise you, right here, these are your key core shortcuts that you're going to be using them so often, they're going to become second nature.
For those of you that have made it to the end of the video, you're probably slightly struggling with shortcuts here and there. Now, yes, I understand, it's hard. There are a lot of shortcuts in Blender. This is all to do with mesh modeling. Hell, I found it very hard to learn all these shortcuts because I was used to Rhino where I would just type in all my commands. I wouldn't go ahead and learn all the shortcuts because I could just type in move or I could type in rotate and whatever and it would just do it for me. However, mesh modeling is completely different. It's not like parametric modeling, it's not like solid modeling from SketchUp. So we have to sort of learn the workflow that comes with mesh modeling. I understand it's a lot and it can be quite a pain, but I truly believe you need to learn all these shortcuts up to this point as a minimum. And then from there, what comes up next, you can sort of just learn with time, because what's going to happen is what we've just covered is the cornerstone of Blender. And you will find that all the shortcuts we've just learned basically everywhere in Blender, from editing meshes to moving things, rotating, scaling, you name it, it's going to have that, especially when it comes to selection and creation and organization. This is the fundamental, which is meshes, origin points, edit mode, and object mode. With that there, we can now go on to the next bit, which is basically creating meshes and influencing and modifying meshes to how we want them to look. That's the whole point of precision modeling. Now, precision modeling, because it's within mesh, it can get a little bit more complicated because there's this huge mountain of fundamentals that you have to learn to be able to accurately and efficiently work with mesh. Anyway, that's my spiel over. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it's the reason I can make content like this. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord community and it's linked down in the description. So if you have any questions or need some help, go over there, give me a little message and I'll do my best to answer. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.